as Eva Perón in Evita and as Marilyn Monroe in Marilyn. Well, last night she appeared before the Queen and Prince Philip in a brand new musical, Starlight Express. A very good morning to Stephanie Lawrence.
Good morning.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Good.
Yes,
was it a
well.
Great night last night?
Very exciting indeed, yes. Mm-hmm. Very exciting.
And you met the royals?
Yes. The Queen had the same colour as my costume on, which is rather nice. It's mm-hmm. a nice sugar pink.
And how did the actual sort of performance go?
I think it went very well indeed. They're always a little bit subdued, you know, mm. because they pay an awful lot of money for the tickets. But I've been to a few of those and been performing in a few of them, and mm. I would say that it went extremely well.
Good.
That's all the jokes and everything.
And well, that's a start, isn't it? Mm. There's a lot of publicity today that Andrew Lloyd Webber very quietly got married yesterday.
I know,
were you aware
sneaky.
Of it at the time or not?
No, he told me just as the Queen went past, and he said, by the way, I've done it. I said, just like that, he didn't tell anybody at all. So it's his birthday yesterday, and I don't know if he actually got married yesterday or a couple of days beforehand.
Oh, I got the impression it was actually yesterday. But
so
perhaps it was, as you say, announced
I'll
yesterday.
I'll ask him this morning.
Knowing him with all his sense of timing, I'm sure it'd be on the same day as his birthday and the
I
same as the first
so, yeah.
sort of proper performance. The thing about Starlight Express, it just intrigues me just because it's such an unusual sort of idea, isn't it?
Definitely.
You can hardly imagine it working.
Well, I think the idea of trains is a very good idea. I mean, that's not such an unusual idea, in as much as we've all been involved in trains in our childhood. You know, I come from Hayling Island, we used to have a steam engine there.
Mm.
But to have people, to put it into a musical it is, and also to have everybody on roller skates is incredible.
We must find out all about the problems of working on roller skates in a minute. Something I would like to do now is just hear one of the songs, which I particularly like. Was it Only He Has the Power to Move Me?
That's right,
it's
yes.
a really nice song, I think. I think this
I
will
like
really
it,
catch
yes.
on. So let's just hear a bit of it now.
Look at me, a woman, calm and in control. No silly girl whose head's always turning. Nobody would guess deep inside my soul, a brand new flame is burning. Only he has the power to move me, and together we'd make the whole world move in sympathy. But I couldn't see.
Yes, I can really see that catching on, can't you?
Oh, definitely.
I think we must explain very quickly, you were saying how expensive the tickets were, and we must explain that it's for charity.
Yes, of course.
Last night, wasn't it?
They're not usually that much.
With the roller skates, the essence of the story is that it's trains racing each other, is that right?
Yes, engines followed by carriages.
Mm-hmm.
The boys are engines and we, the girls, are carriages, different sorts. Smoker,
yeah.
There's a smoking carriage, sleeping carriage, I'm a brand new carriage, and a buffy carriage, and a dining carriage.
And you're all careering about on roller skates?
That's right, yes. And then there's things like freight trains and...
Choreography, I mean, dancing basically is a very precise art. Can you be precise on roller skates? Can you stop
you
dead?
You can, yes, you can stop dead, because you've got things called stoppers that stop you.
Yeah.
But you're at the end, you know, which you use for brakes, and also you can balance on them, so it looks like... you're on point, but you can move around, do any sort of dancing, you can kick. Of course, you can turn on the wheels, so it's, you can do lots of things.
Mm. Well, we'll talk about that a bit more later on,
OK. And the costumes and the makeup looked wonderful.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right, now, how would you like to buzz around on roller skates?
That's right, yes.
Were you a roller skater when you were a little girl?
Well, when I was about six, I was given some Jacko skates. Do you remember those? You used to put them on. Plimsolls, just strap them on.
Oh, yes, that's a very basic roller skate.
Well, I used
were
to skate around those. Yes, well, forwards, but nothing else. Forwards along the streets, you know.
And have you had to relearn all that?
Yes, well, I still went forwards, okay, but I couldn't go backwards, and I couldn't stop backwards, and I couldn't spin round on them, and I certainly couldn't go up and down hills.
And you've had to learn all that?
Yes.
Who taught you? The whole cast must have had to have been.
Well, we've got a
that.
Mixture of skaters, some great skaters and some not so good skaters, and people who've never skated before, you know, even less than what I've done. And We've had a mixture of people helping us. We've had stuntmen, because we do a bit of fighting as well in the... because we have races against each other. We go, I think, up to about 30 miles an hour or 40
really?
Miles an hour, yes. It's great.
Any accidents?
No, not yet. Touch wood. No.
I should think it's always a possibility that you might sort of fall on your backside and lose your dignity completely.
Well, I've slid, but I haven't fallen, you know, because sometimes there's five or six people all linking onto each other, and we come down what I call the wall of death, which ends at about 8 foot, and you have to ride into it, and if somebody goes, invariably you all go, so that's when I slid down.
Do you keep the skates on the whole time?
Yes, all the time. In fact,
and you
I
sing
miss
on
them
and everything?
Yeah.
Have they really become a sort of extension of your leg now?
Oh, yes, definitely. In fact, I nearly fell down the stairs when I had just my boots on, because I'm so used to walking around on the stoppers, and I forgot that I had my own shoes on.
We're about to talk sport, and you were very interested earlier on in watching Torvill and Dean. Are you a great fan?
I am, yes, anyway, but even more so now that I'm skating. And there was sort of like a little bit in the show, and we used to call it Pearl and Dean, because that's what it's more like.
Your character is called
yes, Pearl.
Pearl. From Pearl and Dean, then, let's move on for the moment to a different sort of sport.
Did you give it up?
In 1978.
Any problems?
No, none at all. I was a little bit nervous when I got the part of Eva Perón, because there was a bit in that where I had to do a lighting cue by taking drags from the cigarette, and I thought, oh no, every night I'm going to start again. Mm. But I didn't, and I couldn't even inhale it. It was awful.
Put you right off.
Mm.
Good. Now, something that interests me particularly is that you ran a marathon. Were you doing a Vita then?
Yes, Marilyn? I was doing a Vita, yes.
How did you have the time to train to run a marathon for a start?
Well, I ran into work, which was four miles along the embankment, which was okay, and I ran back sometimes, not very often, but sometimes. Mm-hmm. And I did long distances on Sundays. I did about 14 miles.
Did you?
Yeah. I like that.
What made you want to do them?
I didn't want to. We just all decided in Evita to run as a team, but I was the only one that was accepted, so I had to go.
Nick's been railroaded into it, you see.
I know.
Do you like the railroaded bit, the sort of the play on words with Starlight Express?
That
is, she's quite clever.
Oh, yes, it's very good.
Very quick.
Sorry about that.
No, well, it's just sort of thing.
Are you running for a charity? I did.
Well, I'm not quite sure, really. I'm
it's
just running for insanity at the moment. But,
you must do it for a charity. It's a great way of raising money.
Mm-hmm. Did you enjoy it, actually, the actual running of the marathon itself?
I enjoyed the social day. You know, all the crowds. We had a very sunny day. That wasn't too good because I was used to training in sort of cool weather.
Yes.
And it was a boiling hot day.
Mm.
And I hadn't eaten anything. I hadn't had any pasta the night before, which you must have.
Yes.
And so I got a bit tired, sort of. I hit the wall, as they say, you know, after about 10 miles. But it was a great day, and everybody kept saying, "Don't cry for me, there's a VR."
Did they?
Yes.
Oh, good.
All around the Isle of
Dogs.
So
it kept you going?
The worst bit, I might add, if you do the Isle of Dogs, is the Isle of Dogs. Because you could, as you're running, you could see the front runners that have already done the Isle of Dogs.
Yeah, I can imagine that.
Oh, yes.
But anyway, the marathon this year is on May the 13th. Perhaps, David, you can tell me exactly what the weather's going to be like.
Half a stone.
Was it easy?
Marilyn Monroe only had weight in certain places. How could you make sure you put it on in the right place?
By exercising those places like the bust and... I don't know, really. I'm not really small around the hips, so it was. I sort of filled out quite naturally, but I did exercise a bit for certain places to, you know, just to tone it so it didn't go into flab.
I imagine that's
because I did have chips. It was great.
You strongly identified with Marilyn Monroe, didn't you, in some ways?
Not really, no. Only sort of like a love of animals and...
Did you get to know her?
Clark Gable.
So for us all. Did you get to know her very well, do you think, when you studied her?
Extremely well, yes. She was a very innocent, childlike personality. It's a very sad story, really. Mm. Just manipulated by the movie moguls and...
Do you think that could ever happen now?
No, because in those days they used to put you under contract and make you do a certain amount of film so that you would never stop working. And of course it's you would have to socialise and everything like that and up again at 5 o'clock in the morning. But now we're not manipulated, you know. What is the word?
Never mind, huh? You've been working hard.
You know, we can choose to do what we want.
Well, you're doing Starlight Express at the moment. It starts on the 27th, so you've got a few days
rest
before it.
Thanks.
Have a really good run. I'm looking forward to seeing it. I'm sure everybody all over the country will be coming to see it as well.
Good luck with the marathon.
Thank you. Don't remind me. Thanks for being with us anyway.
Bye-bye.
Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.